Hi, guys. Yeah, that's right. At least seven people taken into custody, and Border Patrol says it's quite possible one or two more people may have gotten away. And this is where it happened, right here behind us at Black's Beach. That boat coming across about 6 in the morning, and it's not far from where another boat washed ashore about 2 weeks ago. Border Patrol says a U.S. Coast Guard ship spotted the Panga around 3:30 Wednesday morning and started following it. At some point before 6, the boat made a sharp turn towards the shore, where at least 7 people, including 2 smugglers, jumped out, one of them managing to try and climb up a nearby cliffside. That's when helicopters had to come in, rescuing that person, pulling them up. That person was taken to the hospital, the others taken into custody. This is the 15th smuggling boat taken into custody by Border Patrol since just October 1st. Remember this night vision video released just a couple of days ago? This came from just right up the street, where at least 9 came ashore. We later learned 6 of those people were Chinese nationals.
Yeah, well, there's no doubt we're seeing an uptick in maritime activity. It's probable that it's related to the increased border infrastructure and the new walls and new barriers.
Yeah, 15 boats in just the last 36 days. That seemed pretty surprising. And we just talked to that U.S. Border Patrol agent who says he thinks that has something to do with the additional funds going into the border wall. Now the smugglers are trying to find different ways in. So I just got some data back here in the last 20 minutes or so. It says about, one thing at least that popped out to me right away is about half as many drugs this year compared to 2 years ago are coming via water. But twice as many people are coming via water. There's other numbers that I'm seeing that are somewhat surprising as well. I'll let you know what I find and share it with you guys at 4 and 5 later on tonight.